So in this lesson, we will be trying to understand the straight lines, how straight lines behave, what are their properties, and how we can understand straight lines in a simple and efficient manner. So first of all, I would like to mention that this lecture is for your reference. Whenever you have any problems in understanding the straight lines or solving problems of straight lines, you can come back and you can have a look at this lecture. So what is a line? Whenever we connect two points, we make a line. These points can be very close to each other. These points can be very far from each other. And this line is an infinite line. So this point can be very close, very tiny distance between them. Even then this line will be infinite. Because when we say line, so line means an infinite straight lines which goes in the direction in which we defined it. So for example, this line I defined using two points. P1 is -1, 4, -1 on the x-axis, y along the y-axis. For this, the other point I took for this line was P2, which is 4, -6. 4 units along the x-axis and 6 units in the negative y direction, -6. So I just joined these two points and then this line is going infinite distance. Similarly, I joined these two points and this line is going infinite distance. So now, if you look at the slope of this line, so how you get the slope of any line or how you draw a line if the slope is given? So this is the first thing we try to understand. So in order to get the slope, what you can do is you start from any point. So you can go right, you can go left. If you go left, you go parallel to x-axis. This is axis and this is parallel to x-axis. You go towards left and then you go downward and you reach at the line again. And you measure the distance in the x direction and in the y direction. Then you take the ratio of change in y divided by x and you get the slope. In the previous lecture, we already derived the equation of this straight line. So this is the equation of this line, y equals x plus 2. If you compare this equation with the equation of the line mx plus c, you will find that m is 1 here. M is 1. And you can see that this is 1 unit in the y direction divided by 1 unit in the x direction, you will get 1. So this is the equation of the straight line. Now this is the point where this line intersects y-axis. So this is the distance from 0 to this point, which is 2 units, 1 and 2. 2 unit is the intercept, y-intercept of this line, which is highlighted here. Y-intercept of this line is 2 units. This is y-intercept. Now if you look at another line, this one. Now this line, what is the slope of this line? This line has an equation, y is equal to -2x plus 2. For example, you don't know this equation and you were asked to derive the equation of this line. You were given only two points, P1 and P2. So how will you reach this equation? Just find the slope of this line and the point where the line intersects the y-axis. So the line intersects the y-axis at 2. So you will proceed like this. You have P1. For example, you were given only P1, -1, 4, and you were given P2. Somebody asked you that these are the two points which makes the line. You connect these two points to make a line, or they say that these two points lie on the line. Find the slope of the line. So what will be the slope? Slope will be equal to difference in y coordinates. So you can take the difference in both ways, like delta y divided by delta x. So what you do, if you are taking y2, this is for example, this is point 1. So we say this is x1 and this is y1. And point 2, we say this is x2 and this is y2. Now remember, this delta y, you can take like this, y2 minus y1. Divided by x2 minus x1. And if you take the minus common from this, minus common, then this will become minus y2 because the sign will change, and this will become plus y1. And you take the minus common from the denominator. I just want to show you something. Therefore, I'm doing this. Otherwise, you can straight away calculate. But I want to show something. If you take minus common, you will be left with minus x2 plus x1. Now, if you simplify, this minus and this minus, both minus when divided, it will become plus. Just like multiplication, when minus multiplied by minus is plus, minus divided by minus is also plus. So then you will be left by, you can change the position, but I first write the same way. Minus y2 plus y1 divided by minus x2 plus x1. Now you can switch the position because two terms are adding. A plus B or B plus A is same. So we can say y1 minus y2 and x1 minus x2. Now look at this equation and this equation. This is the source of error because students do hear a lot of errors. If you take the y2 minus y1, then you must take x2 minus x1. You take first point as p1 and its coordinate as x1, y1, and take the second point p2 and its coordinates x2, y2. Now, for delta y, either you take y2 minus 1 and x2 minus x1, or you take y1 minus y2, but you have to take x1 minus x2 here. Otherwise, the sign will change. If you take once y2 minus y1 and divide it by x1 minus x2, the sign of the slope will change. So instead of line going in this direction, the minus slope means it will be going in this direction. This I am going to explain next, but so just keep this in mind. So now we decided this, that we will use this formula. Y2 minus y1. So then this is our y2. So minus 6 minus y1 is 4 divided by x2, which is 4 minus this minus 1. So minus 6 and minus 4 is minus 10. 4, this will become plus 1. 4 plus 1 is 5. No, 10 divided by 5 is 2, and minus divided by plus is minus. So minus 2 is the slope. So now you can see here that minus 2 is the m. So no line can have either a positive slope or a line can have a negative slope. So what type of line will have a positive slope? So if you look at this, if the line is going like this, whether it's whatever may be the y-intercept, if even this one or the other line could be this one, or it could change like this one. In all of these situations, when the line is going towards right and left like this, upwards and on the leftward direction, you can say, the slope will always be positive. Because from any point, let's say for this line, if I go negative x direction, I'm going negative x direction and negative y direction. So negative y divided by negative x will make this positive. So if I go positive, then I have to go positive in order to reach the line. So it means positive divided by positive will make this slope positive. Now the lines which are going in this direction, what will happen like this one here? If I start from this point in order to find the slope and go this way, so this is negative x, so negative, then I have to go positive in the y. So positive y, because slope is the ratio of the change, so positive y and negative x, the slope will be negative. And even if to go on the other direction, for example, here, or you can do like this. If, for example, you go y positive like this, and then you have to go x negative. So same. So this line, even if you go in this coordinate, what you will be doing? You go first x negative, then y positive. So in any case, if the line is going in this direction, even a little bit of angle like this, even a little bit of angle like this, the slope will be negative. And if the line is going towards like this upward direction, then the slope will be positive. So these are few things. What does equation of line means? When we say y equals x plus 2, we know the slope or intercept. What other information we can get from here? So what does it mean is that, for example, I have x and I have few values of x, 1, 2, 3, 4, and let's say only 4 values. I try 4 values. So what will be the values of y? So if I put x 1, when x equals 1, y equals 1 plus 2, 3. So it means this point 1 and 3 will be on the line. And if you look here, you will see 1 in the x direction and 1, 2 and 3. This point actually lies on the line. So for every value of x, you can find the value of y coordinate on this line. So this is what because this is sometimes called the characteristic equation of the line. Characteristic equation of the line. Because if you know the value of x, you can find the value of y anywhere on the line. X-axis is also a line. This is a line. So what will be the slope of x-axis? So x-axis has a zero slope. X-axis has a zero slope because there is no change in y. A slope is defined as, because this line, if I take any two point on this line, for example, I take this point and this point. So what is delta y between these point? Delta y is zero between these two point. And what is delta x? Delta x is one. So what will be the slope of x-axis? Delta y divided by delta x, which is 0 divided by 1, which is 0. Now come to y-axis. What will be the slope of y-axis? Y-axis is also a line. Y-axis is a line. Isn't it? Y-axis is a line. So what is the slope of y-axis? So what is slope? Slope is delta y between any two points divided by delta x between any two points. Change in y coordinate between any two points. So let's say I take this point and I take this point. So what is the y coordinate of this point? 6. So I say 6 minus, what is the y coordinate of this point? 3. Okay, I got the change in y. What is the x coordinate of this point? 0, because this is on y-axis. So 0 minus, what is the coordinate of this point? What is the x-coordinate of this point? 0. So it means the slope will be 3 divided by 0. And what is, if you divide a number with 0, what you get? Infinite. So the slope of y-axis is infinite. So slope of the y-axis is infinite. So what is the characteristic equation of y-axis? What is the equation which describes y-axis? So we say that characteristic equation of y-axis is x equals 0 on y-axis, x equals 0. This is the equation of the y-axis. You can say that on all y-axis, x is 0. Similarly, you can say the equation of the x-axis as y equals 0. This is the equation of the x-axis. On all x-axis, y is 0. So this is characteristic equation of these axes. For example, take this line. There is a line which is parallel to x-axis. This line. So what will be the equation of this line? On all this line, because this is a line parallel to x-axis, so you would think, okay, the x-axis has an equation y equals 0. So this line should also have the same type of equation. Yes, it is, because it has y equals 1. all this line y is equal to 1. So equation of the line means the equation must be true for every point of the line. So only this y equals 1 can be true for every point of this line. No other equation can be true for this line. Similarly, if the line is like this, if the line is parallel to y-axis, if a line is parallel to y-axis, so it must have an equation something like this, x equals 1, 2, 3, but minus 3. X equals minus 3 is a line which is like this, which is parallel to x. So if you see a line equation, if the normal equation of the line is this, but if you see the equation of the line is given as x minus 3, so you can also say, okay, this is an equation of the line, but this line is parallel to y-axis because there is no y in this. So, but these are special equation of the lines. You can say these are the special. Normally, whenever you talk about a straight line, you say straight line has an equation of y equals mx plus c. So this is the normal equation of the straight line. I'm just trying to enhance your knowledge a little bit so that you can better understand straight lines. That straight lines can be of any type. So if a straight line is in this direction, even so the slope will be, because there can be only two directions. One is this one, the other is this one. Otherwise, if the line is straight, then it's parallel to x-axis. And otherwise, if the line is vertical, it is parallel to y-axis. So then it will have an equation something like this. So this is what you should understand, that straight lines, how straight lines behave. Now, I will show you what are perpendicular lines and what are parallel lines.